What's the backstory on Fox Disney? Is it just about Mr. Murdoch's age?
It's been a little perplexing, and I know I'm not the only one who's confused.
Yes.
Trying to figure out why this company, which seemed to be in expansionary mode, would all of a sudden be open to selling itself, threw me for a loop. I know it's thrown a lot of investors for a loop. I have theories. We don't have concrete ideas. One idea I floated was this a way to solve the Disney succession issue? In other words, James Murdoch as CEO of Disney, for example. So it's a trade of assets plus James to Disney for equity.
But this goes to Class A, Class B. Media is play toy of the wealthy. And I get that. And I understand with great respect for Mr. Murdoch, he started out somewhat basic, even though his father had done that well. In your world, it's Media Monday, Merger Tuesday, Merger Wednesday. Next year, are we going to have a great transaction and combination of these companies into three or four players?
I mean, it's possible. I think there are real efficiencies in concentrating, at least for the individual companies, there's efficiencies. We can put aside the diversity of voice argument that one probably should make as a society. But from a pure business perspective, are they better off as larger entities? Sure, you can drive a lot of costs out.
I want to get in the next section to, you know, Facebook and Google and advertising world and all that. But how is media doing right now? I mean, this, you know, movie goes down in flames and there's this show that does well, Game of Thrones or whatever. But what's the state of your world right now in content?
I think there's a lot of fear. I think that certainly the media companies and many of their investors are more than a little concerned that the world's coming to an end. You know, and not without some justification that at least things are changing. It's really hard to say that it's changing faster than it was changing before. The world's always changed. The media industry has always changed. I think there is concern that when you have a Netflix out there who doesn't necessarily have the same, for lack of a better word, profit motive, or doesn't have the same sort of obligations to drive dividends, that they're competing. But that's a small factor. You know, I mean, I think anyone in the UK could point to something like the BBC and say, look, you can survive in a world where there's a non-commercial player.